Morning. Tony Orlando, let me give you a heads up here. What we're about to watch is a New Year's show. I wouldn't want any of our viewers to wake up from a deep sleep and think they had somehow slept through another year. This particular New Year goes back nearly 30 years, and none of those on stage had any inkling of what lay just over the horizon. Gerald Ford was president of the United States. Jack Nicklaus had won the Masters and the PGA, missed the U.S. Open by 2 and the British Open by 1. Tiger Woods had not yet been born. The Berlin Wall stood. So did the Soviet Union. For this New Year's show, Tony and Telma and the gang invited Totie Randall for a return visit. This time he is joined by the pride of Nashville, cousin Minnie Pearl. There can be no question that the grand old Opry in Nashville has been the beacon and driving force for the country music revolution in this country. There was a time when there were country music radio and television programs all over the dial, and all of them had loyal audiences. The WLS Barn Dance in Chicago, some of you will remember, with the Denning Sisters. The Ozark Jubilee with the great Red Foley. The Midwestern Hayride in Cincinnati, Ohio, which was the real professional birthplace of Chet Atkins. The Renfro Valley Gang in Kentucky, and a dozen others. One by one, they faded from the scene, and the best of those performers headed for Nashville because the grand old Opry still stood. And for millions of Americans, the most visible symbol of the Grand Ole Opry was cousin Minnie Pearl. In real life, of course, a very cultured lady and a pillar of the community. She played the bumpkin as well as anyone ever did, with a price tag hanging from her hat. And that signature, I don't know if I can do it. Howdy, I can't do it. Howdy, you know, I'm just so proud to be here. It should be quite a New Year's party on the Tony Orlando and Dawn Rainbow Hour.
Ladies and gentlemen, Tony Orlando and Dawn.
Chug a log and
celebrate,
shout.
Celebrate, dance to the music.
Gonna stimulate some action. Gonna get some satisfaction. Gonna find out what it's all about.
What it's all
Lord,
about.
Yeah.
What it's all about.
After midnight, we're gonna let it all hang down.
After midnight, yeah.
I hear.
After midnight. Oh.
After midnight, I'm gonna shake your tambourine.
After midnight. Oh.
Gonna give an exhibition. Gonna tell you what New Year's is all about.
What New Year's all about.
Sing to the night sky.
Oh. After midnight, yeah. We're gonna let it all hang out. Hey. After midnight, we're gonna chuckle up and shout.
Happy New Year to you too.
Gonna stimulate some action.
Action.
Get some satisfaction.
I hear you. I wanna hear it again.
What it's all about.
What it's all about. What it's all about.
Although we're 3 hours away from the big moment, there was a strange rumble in this room. you know, a little bit more stranger than usual. So before we go a little bit further, if we can just, my director doesn't know I'm going to do this. Before we go on with the show, you got to see why the rumble is happening. I'm going to jump off the stage. Give me a count of three. Don't let them see them yet.
One, two, three!
Oh, we're going to have fun with you guys tonight.
Thank you very much, ladies. It really is. It's the big night tonight. Ring out the old and bring in the new.
And if those rings have big diamonds, make sure I get two.
You know, I love New Year's Eve, Telma. I really do. I mean, I can remember every single New Year's Eve party I've ever been to, and they were sensational.
Now, if you could remember them, how good could they have been?
Guys are all going, oh, God. I'll tell you something new. I'm a New Yorker. So when that 12 o'clock comes, thank you, Mama. When that 12 o'clock comes, you know what? I wish I was right in the middle of that Times Square, standing right there in New York City, right in Times Square with that big crowd.
Well, if you're going to be in Times Square, you might as well be with a big crowd.
Well, I agree with Tony. I love New Year's Eve.
Yeah. And you know why you love New Year's Eve, especially this one? Because in just a few hours, this fantastic and wonderful nation that we're blessed to be in is celebrating its 200th birthday.
It's exciting. That's really exciting.
Yeah, it means we're almost through with those bicentennial minutes.
You gotta be kidding, Joyce. Those bicentennial minutes are really, I mean, they're commemorating that very historic occasion when in 1776, your ancestors signed the Declaration of Independence.
Honey, my ancestors were picking cotton.
Come to think of it, my ancestors were picking coconuts. Well, to all you ancestors who created this great country, God bless you. And now we're moving on with the show. And I know a lot of you out there are getting ready to go out at that midnight stroke so you can just let it all hang out, as they say. So we're going to introduce our guests so that we can psych you up and get you in the mood for the best New Year's Eve parties wherever they may be, you may ever have. Starting with a wonderful actor and a comedian who has been a television star for 25 years. And in that 25 years, he's given us 100 years worth of laughter. Would you welcome Mr. Tony Randall? Going on with our next guest, and I am truly excited because we have with us for the first time the queen of the Grand Ole Opry, comedy queen of country, Nashville's own Howdy. Say howdy for me.
Howdy!
Howdy, Miss Minnie Pearl!
Yeah!
Give me a W.
G.
Give me a D.
G.
Give me a Y.
Y.
Say it.
Y.
Living in Hollywood, it's Tony Orlando and Dawn, featuring Joyce Vincent Wilson and Telma Hopkins, with tonight's guest star Minnie Pearl and special guest star Tony Randall.
You're watching Tony Orlando and Dawn on the Good Life TV Network.
Ladies and gentlemen, one of the great ladies of country music, country comedy, and the Grand Ole Opry itself, Miss Minnie Pearl. You know when that opening, when they all yelled out, howdy?
Yes, sir.
Boy, that word has gotten a lot of mileage out of that one word, hasn't it?
Yes, put a lot of pork chops in the smokehouse.
I've got to congratulate you, because recently I watched the country the music special that was on TV, and you were named to the Country Music Hall of Fame.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
You had a good time this week.
Oh, yeah, but just one thing's bothered me.
What's that?
Well, I've been here a whole week, and you haven't kissed me on my lips one time.
Shouldn't you feel bad? I haven't kissed Tony Randall either.
Go ahead, lover boy. Lay one on me.
Well, okay. Can I just feel like, can I get country?
Yeah.
Get down home country?
Yeah. This gets better all the time.
Now you say howdy.
Yes, sir.
I'll say
howdy.
And I'll say howdy.
Yeah. Yeah.
Tell me something. Does a country girl mind kissing a fellow with a mustache?
Honey, don't nobody mind going through a little brush to get to a picnic.
Ladies and gentlemen, continue laughing and I'll join you, Miss Minnie Pearl.
Beautiful. He's so young, so handsome, so unavailable. But I still look, as I said, it's like going down to the depot and watching the trains go by. You love to hear the whistle, even if it ain't going nowhere. We got a train goes through Grinder Switch, where I come from. Grinder Switch is my hometown. It's a little town there in Centerville. It's about a mile this side of resume speed. And that is the greatest town. It really is. And there's a tunnel on the track of the train that comes in there. And it's not a very long tunnel, and they don't turn the lights on. And it's dark. It's wonderful. And one day, me and sister was going into the Grand Ole Opry, and a fella in that tunnel right across from me just grabbed a hold to me and kissed me. I didn't know what to do. I didn't know whether to bake a cake or cut a watermelon. I ain't never been around much except my time I went to town, leaned over to tie my shoe, and got caught in a revolving door. I made 300 round trips in that thing before I could get out. Scared Mammy to death. She kept on saying, "Speak to me, Minnie, speak to me." I did every time I went around. "Howdy, Mammy, howdy, Mammy." No, I tell you, I didn't know what to say to that fella that kissed me, and he didn't know what to say, and... Finally, we got out where it was light, and he said, "You know that tunnel back there cost over $1 million. I said, "You know it is worth every cent of it." No, I talk about kissing. I ain't been kissed in so long, I forgot whether it's done by drawing in your breath or blowing it out. They say kissing spreads germs. I sure have spent a lot of healthy evenings in my life. Well, let me tell you, I went down here. Was it this your hotel where I was staying while I was out here? And when I first checked in, I'll have you know I found out something about these hotels out here in California, and I'm not going to have it. I went down and told the manager. I said, there's a feller up there right across the court from me. There's some rooms across there, and there's a feller up there, and he's taking a shower and got the shade all the way to the top. I ain't gonna stand for it. And the feller said, I'll go up there and look. And he went up there, and he said, I can see right across there, there's a window with the shade all the way to the top, but I don't see no feller taking a shower. I said, will you get up on that chest of drawers and look? But while I was out here, Telva and Joyce got me a date. They did, sure enough. Took two of them to do it, but they done. He was cute, he was eligible, he was breathing. I won't go out with him if they ain't alive. I'm hard to please. He was thin, there's the thinnest fella I ever seen. If he hadn't had an Adam's apple, he wouldn't have had no shape at all. Everybody's trying to get thin. Miss Lizzie Tinkle, Miss Grinder Switch. She's got so thin they have to starch her underwear to hold her up. She's had her face lifted, too. They overdone it. She looks like a horse that's been rid hard and put away wet. They stretched her face the further. Every time she blinks her eyes, she pulls her stockings up. The girls, we made it up. We was gonna tell one another how many times we got kissed last night. See, when they got me this date, and they went out with their fellers, and we was gonna tell one another this morning at rehearsal how many times we got kissed last night, by how many times we said the word morning, and nobody know what we was talking about. And so Telva come in and she said, good morning this morning, pretty morning this morning. Joyce come in and she said, good morning this morning, pretty morning this morning, pretty morning in the morning, this morning be a pretty morning in the morning. Made me sick. Then I come in, you know what I said? Howdy!
Tonight let's tear the goalpost down.
We'll have these moments to remember.
A quiet song, some noisy fun. Tonight's our chance to sing along.
We will have these moments to remember.
That you have to share is music to my ears. Oh, another night's, another day's may find us gone our separate ways.
We'll have these moments to remember. To remain.
have you back with us again. It's really great.
Thank you. It's wonderful to be with you. I love you both. Remember the fun we had with that wonderful song we did? Hubba, hubba, hubba.
Just got in. Hubba, hubba, hubba. Give me some skin.
Yeah, that was great.
And we had the tongue twister there? The boogly woogly bugler boy of Company B. The boogly woogly bugler boy of Company B.
Yeah.
Oh, that's music. And people love fine music like that. Well, I have another song for you now.
Really?
Oh, really, a wonderful World War I 1916 vintage song.
Oh, I'm glad we didn't ask for an old one.
Come on, you'll love it. You really will.
Okay, how does it go?
It's very simple. Sister Susie sewing shirts for soldiers.
Sister Susie sewing shirts for soldiers. Shoulders.
Don't hazard it again. That was close enough. Such skill at sewing shirts our shy young Sister Susie shows.
Ooh. Such skill at showing shirts. I'm sighing on...
You'll work on it. You'll get it. It's not difficult. Yes, yes. Some soldiers send epistles. Easy now.
Soldiers send epistles.
Send epistles. It's coming. Don't be afraid of it. Yes. Say they'd sooner sleep in thistles.
Say they'd sooner sleep in thistles.
Sleep in thistles. It's coming. You see how easy it is? Yeah. Now, the last line is the only really tough one.
Okay.
Then the saucy, soft, short shirts for soldiers Sister Susie sews.
Then the saucy, soft, short shirts for soldiers Sister Susie sews.
Sister Susie's sewing in the kitchen on a singer. There's miles and miles of flannel on the floor and up the stairs.
Her father says it's rotten getting mixed up with the cotton and sitting on the needles that she leaves up on the chairs.
And should you knock at our street door, Ma whispers, "Come inside." Then when you ask where Susie is, she's...